Maraming Pilipinong saintipiko ang kinikilala sa ibang bansa dahil sa kanilang galing at kontribusyon. Isa na riyan ang evolutionary biologist at geneticist na si Dr. Michael Purugana na nasa Pilipinas ngayon. Enero noong nakaraang taon, itinalagang Dean for Science sa New York University si Dr. Puruganan. Hawak niya rin ang prestigyosong titulo na Dorothy Schiff Professor of Genomics. Nagtapos ng Bachelor of Science in Chemistry si Dr. Puruganan sa UP Diliman. Sa Columbia University naman sa Amerika, niya nakuha ang kanyang Master's in Chemistry. Tinapos naman niya ang kanyang Doctorate Degree sa Botany, minor in Global Policy sa University of Georgia. So, magandang umaga.
Magandang umaga.
Dr. Puruganan, and congratulations sa iyong bagong title. You've been Dean of Science at New York University for just a year now.
Yes,
okay, you bring prestige to the country and to the race. And speaking of race, bilang isang geneticist, you've been thinking about the question, ano ba ang Pinoy o sino ba ang tunay na Pinoy?
Yeah.
Ano bang sagot dyan?
Yeah, so, talagang nalilitaw ako pag tinatanong sa akin, what is a Filipino? And I remember a year ago, there was an ad campaign about what is your mix? And so one of the things I did was I actually genetically tested myself. I did an analysis of my genome, and I found that, of course, I'm mixed. I have all of this Spanish and Chinese and Malaysian. And in the Philippines, kasi ang position natin, madaming Spanish, Chinese, Arabs coming here. All of us are a mix. So genetically, every Filipino, I think, is really a mix. So it's something that's interesting to find out because in our DNA, sa genes natin, nakikita natin yung history natin. As a nation and as
okay, well, speaking of DNA, kasi pag tinatanong yung tanong na yan dito, parang parang skin deep lang yung right. Tingin ng mga tao, ano bang itsura ng isang tao, right. Na Pilipino ba o hindi. But right. You look at the DNA, para right. Sa mga ordinaryong manonood, pakipaliwanag lang, ano ba tong DNA na inaaral mo?
Ang DNA natin, yun ang genetic code natin sa lahat ng mga cells natin, sa katawan o sa lahat ng mga living organisms, meron silang DNA. Yun ang mga genes na nagbibigay ng itsura sa atin, na nagbibigay ng mga our look and what our characteristics are. And in the last mga 20 years especially, may mga new technologies to look at our DNA and all of our genetic material very easily. And here in the Philippines, for example, we have the Philippine Genome Center now that's being established that will give capabilities to the Philippines to look at our DNA of humans, of us, of all our organisms in the on the country and try to understand what it's about and tell us something about the history and what makes us what we are, what makes us as a living organism what we are.
Okay, so going back to that, the original question, what is a Filipino? Ano ba yung Filipino? So ang sinasabi mo, naiiba ang yung ordinaryong Pinoy dahil mas mixed siya kaysa sa ibang lahi? Are we saying that most humans naman are a mix of different kinds of people?
Most humans are a mix of different kinds of people.
So it doesn't really make us unique.
It doesn't. It doesn't make us unique, but I think it does make us unique, and I think this is going to be interesting. Now, I think we have more groups coming in to be mixed on the island. So I think Filipino is a cultural sense, but genetically, we're a mixture of everybody else who's come to these islands, and there are so many groups that have come to these islands in the last 10,000 years. So
it's really, as opposed to, anong lahi yung mas pure na pag sinabi mong ito sila, yung wala masyadong nahalo doon? How about mga Aitas?
Mga Aitas, kung dito sa Filipinas, I think the Aitas would be the ones that would be the closest. But even the Aitas, probably, their DNA has mixtures from Taiwan and Polynesia, I would suspect. I don't know. And see, this is one of the things that would be good to study because it would tell something about our history of all the people in the country. So this is
okay, so I guess yun ang isang mission ng Philippine Genome Center.
Yeah,
saan naka-base yun?
The Philippine Genome Center is based in the University of the Philippines system.
Sa UP.
Yeah, so I'm on the advisory board and I'm really excited about it.
So anong mga applications nito? Meron mga commercial applications yung gagawin itong Philippine Genome Center?
Well, there are groups now studying dengue fever, for example.
Looking
at ways to analyze dengue the dengue pathogen. There are people working on plants and crops, important for improvement, and in forensics, looking at human genomes, to look at forensics to find diseases, genetic diseases that might be prevalent in Filipinos.
So yung mga sinasabing genetically modified organisms, ano yan? Kasama yan sa larangan ng ginagawa mo,
well,
genetics?
Well, no, yeah, it's part of genetics, although I don't do genetically modified organisms.
Pero posibleng gawin yun ng Philippine Genome Center?
Yeah, pwede gawin. The technology is here in the Philippines already to do genetic modification, for example, in UP.
Yung isang nabasa ko, pwede mong malaman yung vulnerabilities ng isang individual sa diseases based on yung analysis nga ng DNA,
right.
Ng genetic history
right.
niya, no? So I guess that would be very useful for a lot of people.
That would be very useful and very interesting because we know that madami mga diseases may genetic component. Kahit na diabetes, for example, has a genetic component, kidney disease, and all of those diseases. And we know very little about Filipinos and our genes and what is it that makes us vulnerable to many of these diseases. So to study the genome of humans would be very important.
Halimbawa, pwede mang pumunta sa Philippine Genome Center at mapa-analyze yung kanyang DNA para malaman kung yung pamilya niya, yung mga anak niya, magkakaroon ng susceptibility to, say, cancer or diabetes.
Absolutely. I mean,
pwede yun.
Yeah, pwede. I mean, right now, of course, they're developing the technologies, but that's extremely possible. In the United States, that's done routinely already. So this is something that hopefully in the Philippines we'll have the capability and the technology to do.
Stem cell therapy, that's kind of has a lot of buzz these days, no? May connection ba yan dito sa larangan niyo?
Wala naman, except that in biology it's very exciting. Stem cell work is very exciting. And in NYU, where I'm the dean, one of our professors there works on stem cells. And in fact, I asked him about stem cell therapy. The problem is that while there's a lot of excitement about stem cells and its opportunities, in stem cell therapy, major questionable, but it's not clear whether it's still useful or can be worked. So people who are doing stem cell therapies, they should look very carefully as to whether it's really what they want and whether it's working. And there are dangers to it also, so to be very careful about those.
Okay. Well, you sound very excited about your field of science. Yeah. Not too many Filipinos get advanced degrees in science, no? Yeah. But obviously it can be a fruitful career.
Oh, absolutely. So, I went to public school here in Manila. You know, I went to UP Diliman. And when you're growing up, I want to be a scientist. And what do? You have to get advanced degrees. But now there's a lot of opportunities. And what
even in the Philippines?
Me, even in the Philippines. We have PhD programs already in Ateneo, in the UP system, in La Salle. There's a lot of excitement. And then a lot of our students are going abroad and getting advanced degrees. So we have really well-known...
But are they coming back here?
Some of them are really wanting to come back. A lot of us are involved with projects in the Philippines. A lot of the younger ones are really thinking about coming back. One, for example, Reyna Reyes, a famous astrophysicist. She finished in Princeton. She's in Chicago. She wants to come back. She'll probably be back in a year, although she's won the top award in astrophysics in the United States. And there are a lot of scientists, even though they're not coming back, they're giving a lot of, like me, they're coming back and contributing by consulting and teaching and doing other things here in the Philippines as well.
So it's great. It's another, I guess, it's another way of reversing the brain drain.
Absolutely, and I think we should do that. And it's very important for our country to do that.
Well, thank you for your contributions. Maraming salamat sa pag-guest niyo, Dr. Michael Puruganan, Dean for Science ng New York University.